بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، وأفضل الصلاة وأتم التسليم على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين سيدنا وحبيبنا ومولانا محمد الصادق الأمين المبعوث رحمة للعالمين، وعلى آله الطاهرين الطيبين، وعلى أصحابه أجمعين، وعلى أزواجه أمهات المؤمنين، وعلى ذريته إلى يوم الدين. سبحانك اللهم لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا إنك أنت العليم الحكيم. اللهم علمنا ما ينفعنا وانفعنا بما علمتنا وزدنا اللهم علما وعملا متقبلا امين يا رب العالمين. بالاسناد المتصل الى الامام ابو بكر ابن ابي الدنيا صاحب كتاب المحتضرين. The connected chain to the author of this blessed book, the book of those at the time of death. كتاب المحتضرين, he said, Hadith number 177 on page 140 of the Dar ibn Hazm edition, edited by Muhammad Khair Ramadan Yusuf. قال الإمام, إمام ابن أبي الدنيا said, حدثني محمد, قال حدثنا شعيث ابن محرز, قال حدثنا صالح المري, قال سمعت يزيد الرقاشي يقول بلغنا أن عامر بن عبد الله لما احتضر بكى, فقيل له ما يبكيك. News reached us, or reports reached us, that عامر بن عبد الله, one of the great imams of the Tabi'in and pious scholars, at the time of death, on his deathbed, wept and was asked, why are you weeping? قال هذا الموت غاية الساعين, said, here is death, the finish or the goal or the terminal of all those who are marching, or those, all those who are on their way. So sa'i is to rush also. So the end points of all of those who are on their way. Wa inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. Wallahi ma abki jaza'an min al-mawti. I swear that I am not weeping out of fear of death, ولكن أبكي على حر النهار وبرد الليل. But I weep over hot days and cool nights. So just remember that, and it will become clear in the next few reports what exactly he means by that. I weep over hot days and cool nights. وإني أستعين بالله على مصرعي هذا بين يدي. And I all but ask Allah for help over my demise, which is imminent, right in front of him. So مصرع is death, it's like موت, but it is a little bit more dramatic than Maut is more like destruction, death, demise. قال حدثنا أحمد بن إبراهيم النكري قال حدثنا بشر, because Abdullah, I don't read حدثنا Abdullah because this is Ibn Abi Dunya, right? His name is Abdullah ibn Muhammad, that's him. حدثنا أحمد بن إبراهيم النكري قال حدثنا بشر ابن عمر الزهراني قال حدثنا همام عن قتادة أن عامر بن عبد الله لما حضر جعل يبكي. Again, حضر, when he was at the point of dying, he began to weep. فقيل له ما يبكيك, he asked him why. قال ما أبكي جزعا من الموت, not out of fear of death, or as a reaction against death, no, ولا حرصا على الدنيا, and not because I wish to remain longer or because I feel that I will miss anything of this world, ولكن أبكي على ظمأ الهواجر وقيام ليالي الشتاء. But rather I am weeping over the intense thirst of noon times. So هواجر plural of هجيرة, the noon times, the hottest part of the day, وقيام ليالي الشتاء, and standing up during the nights of winter, meaning the long winter nights. So now it's becoming clearer what he means in the previous hadith, right? So he is going to be missing what? Worship during those times, those long times of praying. قال حدثني عمر بن الحسين قال حدثنا سعيد بن عامر قال حدثنا همام بن يحيى قال بكى عامر بن عبد الله في مرضه الذي مات فيه بكاء شديدا. Same man wept very hard in his last illness. فقيل له ما يبكيك يا أبا عبد الله. Was asked, why are you weeping, O Abu Abdullah? قال آية في كتاب الله. This one verse in the book of Allah, إنما يتقبل الله من المتقين. Allah accepts only from those who beware Him. حدثنا عبد الله قال حدثني محمد قال حدثنا داود بن حبري قال حدثنا الحسن بن دينار عن الحسن يمينين البصري قال دخل عامر بن عبد الله على رجل يعوده. عامر بن عبد الله, now in the time when he was still healthy, went in to see a man who was sick, so he was paying him a visit. فرآه كأنه جزع من الموت, and he saw that man was as if afraid of death and deeply troubled by the prospect of death. فقال أتجزع من الموت أو أتجزع من الموت. Are you afraid of death? والله ما الموت فيما بعده. I swear to you by Allah that death is nothing in comparison to what comes after it, except as إلا كركدة عنز, like a goat rushing to some spot. See how fast the goat goes and reaches its spot? That's how much death is in comparison to what comes after it. Meaning, and most probably time-wise, what he means by that, and difficulty-wise. قال حدثني محمد بن عمر المقدمي وهارون بن عبد الله وغيرهما قالوا حدثنا سعيد بن عامر عن حزم أنه قال قال محمد بن واسع وهو في الموت. Now the same man, again محمد, a different man, محمد بن واسع, and this one was also a pious faqih from Basra who refused to become judge when a judgeship was offered to him, because they considered that judgeship was too involving in this world and was also fraught with risks as to religion, because temptations might arise, bribes might be offered, partisanship might occur between people pulling the judge this way or that way and not being happy with their judgment, and also because it paid well, actually, in order to prevent bribes. So it paid well, so that was all, these were all causes for some very scrupulous people, overly scrupulous people, to reject the post of or the appointment of judgeship. وَهُوَ فِي الْمَوْتِ, so he said in the throes of death, يَا إِخْوَتَاهُ, O my brothers, تَدْرُونَ أَيْنَ يُذْهَبُ بِي, you know where I'm going to be taken? يُذْهَبُ بِي وَاللَّهِ الَّذِي لَا إِلَهِ إِلَّا هُوَ. I swear that I'm going to be taken by Allah, besides whom there is none. أَوْ يَعْفُو عَنِّي, to hellfire. Or he will forgive me. قال حدثنا أحمد بن إبراهيم بن كثير ابن كثير قال حدثني إبراهيم بن عبد الرحمن بن مهدي قال حدثني مضر قال حدثني عبد الواحد ابن زيد قال حضرت محمد بن واسع عند الموت فجعل يقول لأصحابه عليكم السلام إلى النار أو يعفو الله. So the same man was saying to his companions around him, upon you peace, I am going to hellfire, or Allah will forgive me. قال حدثني إبراهيم ابن عبد الله الهروي قال حدثنا إسماعيل بن إبراهيم عن يونس بن عبيد أنه قال دخلنا على محمد بن واسع نعوده فقال وما يغني عني ما يقول الناس إذا أخذ بيدي ورجلي فألقيت في النار. Can also read it, إذا أخذ بيدي ورجلي فألقيت في النار. So we entered with others, the narrator is saying, to see Muhammad ibn Wasi' on his bed where he lay ill. And he said at one point, what good is it to me what people say when I shall be seized by my hand and foot and thrown into the fire? Or my hands and feet and thrown into the fire. So if one is seizing him, then it will be my hand and foot. If two, then my hands and feet. وَالْعِيَاذُ بِاللَّهِ. So a terrific scene that he's imagining, and he's replying to those who are saying to him, no, you did good, you did, which is a duty also. But he's also teaching them back that don't rely on your good works. And also, we can, no one is sure, no one can be sure. That is the wariness that is taught to us by the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and in the Holy Quran. قال به إليه قال حدثنا عبد الله قال حدثنا أحمد بن إبراهيم وغيره قالوا حدثنا سعيد بن عامر قال حدثني صاحب لنا قال لما ثقل محمد بن واسع كثر الناس عليه في العيادة فدخلت. So when the same man became sick, lots and lots of people were visiting him as he lay sick, and I entered. فَإِذَا قَوْمٌ قِيَامٌ وَآخَرُونَ قُعُودٌ فَقَعَدْتُ. So lo and behold, there were lots of people standing, lots of people sitting, so I sat. فَأَقْبَلَ عَلَيَّ, he turned towards me. فَقَالَ أَخْبِرْنِي, tell me, he said, مَا يُغْنِي عَنِّي هَؤُلَاءِ إذا أخذ بناصيتي وقدمي غدا فألقيت في النار. Tell me what good are these for me? What do they suffice me? Or in what way can they possibly help me? When tomorrow I shall be seized by my forelock and my feet and thrown into the fire. We seek refuge in Allah. So he's there, he's already imagining himself being judged. He has no desire to hear anything but something related to that. قال حدثنا عبد الله قال حدثنا أحمد بن إبراهيم ابن كثير قال حدثنا العلاء عن أبي عبد الصمد العمي قال سمعت مالك بن دينار دينار في مرضه يقول. مالك بن دينار, one of the great imams also of zuhud and wara, يعني simple living and piety and scrupulousness, famous for his asceticism, and he was in his last illness. And this Hafiz Abu Abd al-Samad al-Ammi said that he heard him say, يقول وهو من آخر كلام سمعته يتكلم به. And it was among his last, very last words that I heard him say in life. Said, ما أقرب النعيم من البؤس. البؤس is the same as البأس. So adversity or misfortune or calamity. He said, how close they are together, bliss and calamity. يعقبان, they follow closely one upon another. ويوشكان زوالا, and they quickly vanish. So then he is speaking of the bliss and adversity of this life. And they are nothing in comparison to the next life. And Allah knows best what he actually meant. طيب وبه إليه قال حدثنا عبد الله قال أحمد وحدثني أبو عبد الرحمن عن أبي قطن. So this is the same Ahmad ibn Ibrahim ibn Kathir in the previous sanad, in the previous chain of transmission. عن أبي قطن عن حزم عن مالك بن دينار أنه قال كنا عنده قبل أن يموت. So actually this is Hazm saying we were with Malik ibn Dinar before his death. بيومين أو ثلاثة, by two or three days. قال أظنه كان به بطن. I think there was, he was ailing from something in his belly. So anything in the belly, from it could be whatever, jaundice or cancer or whatever, that is all subsumed under the term batn, which means belly, which refers here to a disease. And the Prophet ﷺ mentioned it in one hadith where he said that the one who dies from batn is a shaheed, is a martyr. This is a huge honor and more than a great consolation for anyone who is suffering from that, but they are told of it. You know, this is something that should not be missed by a bedside reminder from relative or counselor, that, you know, this makes you a shaheed, so be happy, console yourself and think upon it, because then no one above you except Siddiqs and Anbiya, Allahu Akbar, in paradise. And the categories of shaheed really should be studied over and over again, because there are so many that if they die in the situation that they are in, they are considered shaheed, not just the one on the battlefield defending the word of Allah and his Prophet, such as the student, for example, dying in that activity or traveling towards that activity, even considered a shaheed, the one drowning, the victim of a fire, and so on and so forth. So he said, I think that he was dying from that, for something in his belly. فقالوا نصنع له قلية. Let us make for him a قلية. And it might be al-qilyu, in both of them being the same root, and explained, latter is explained as something which is made from burnt citrus rind or burnt lemon rind. So maybe they pulverized it to powder and used it as a some kind of medication that would benefit that disease against that disease. فقال إني لأرجو أن يكون الله يعلم أني لم أكن أريد البقاء في الدنيا ولا لفرجي. Said, I truly hope that Allah knows, meaning that this thing will be true, that I can say this truly. When you say, I hope that Allah knows, it's not that you doubt that he knows, it's that the content of that knowledge, if Allah knows it, it means that it's true. And I'm claiming what? I'm claiming that, namely, that I do not wish to remain in this world, whether for my belly or my underbelly. And another wording of this same hadith says, لا لفرج ولا لبطن, not for belly nor for underbelly. So farj is genitals, and so button and farj is saying, in other words, yani do what you are supposed to do, help me, and I might take the medication, but it is not out of fear of death or desire to remain one moment longer than what Allah decides for me. As you see from other reports, committed, you see, to that if one sees good for themselves in the hereafter as a rest from the fitna of this world or and so forth, that they might wish for it or even ask for it, but not, one is never sure. One might always have a greater good in remaining in dunya and do more of what they were regretting they were leaving behind, namely standing in prayer and doing acts of worship. And you will see more of this in the coming few narrations. قال أحمد حدثني أبو محمد عن أبي عيسى قال دخلوا على مالك بن دينار وهو في الموت, the same man, same imam, فجعل يقول, and he said on his deathbed, لمثل هذا اليوم كان دؤوب أبي يحيى. So Abu Yahya is the patronym of, or the technonym of Malik ibn Dinar. So he's speaking of himself, and he's saying, for such a day, I was preparing myself. For such a day, I was studiously, very carefully preparing myself. Du'ub, du'ub, like da'b, like habit, studious habit. So subhanAllah, to take care of thinking of that day and preparing oneself for that day, that's what he means. وقال أحمد حدثني عمرو بن محمد ابن أبي رزين أنه قال بعض أصحابنا أن مالك بن دينار قال عند الموت. Again, another report about the same man, who said at the time of death, لولا أني أخاف أن يكون بدعة لأمرتكم إذا أنا مت فشدت يدي بشريط, or فشدت يدي بشريط. Said, were it not that I fear that it would be an innovation, a misguided innovation, means in this sense, I would order you, when I die, to tie up my hands, to tie me down to some place. Tie me down to some place. Yani the person who is prepared for burial is washed and perfumed with camphor, and then stopped up, and then tied up in the shroud. But as for tying down the hands to some place, to some fixed place, as if he cannot be removed from that place, so that's what he's saying here. It seems to be that's what he's meaning, and he's saying that would be an innovation and but otherwise I would order you to do that. فإذا أنا قدمت على الله فسألني وهو أعلم. So that when I go forward to appear before Allah, to be judged, and then he asks me, and he knows best. He doesn't need to find out from me, but he will ask me, ما حملك على ما صنعت? What made you do what you did? What pushed you to do that? قلت يا ربي لم أرضى لك نفسي قط. Oh my Lord, I am not pleased for you with myself at all. يعني how can I bring myself to come before you when I feel too ashamed? So he is as if allegorizing his state of mind through this story of himself being tied down and then being asked why he did that. به إليه قال حدثني أحمد بن إبراهيم قال حدثني محمد بن أحمد قال حدثني محمد بن أبي يزيد الخراساني عن مهدي بن ميمون أنه قال رأيت حسان بن أبي سنان أحسبه في مرضه قيل له كيف تجدك. حسان بن سنان البصري, one of the early Sufis of Basra also, who narrates from Al-Hasan al-Basri and Thabit al-Bunani, the students of Anas ibn Malik. So he's a contemporary of the Tabi'in and a junior one among them, or a Tabi' al-Tabi'in, the contemporary of the Tabi'in. And he was asked on his deathbed, how do you feel? قَالَ بِخَيْرٍ إِنْ نَجَوْتُ مِنَ النَّارِ. Well, if I can be safe from the fire. قِيلَ فَمَا تَشْتَهِي? What would you like? This is a good bedside question to ask of anyone sick, even very sick. What would you like? قَالَ لَيْلَةً بَعِيدَةً مَا بَيْنَ الطَّرَفَيْنِ. A night that is very long between its beginning and its end. أُحْيِي مَا بَيْنَ طَرَفَيْهَا. Then I can bring alive what is between its two extremities, meaning with worship, with zikr, standing up in prayer, reading Quran, making zikr, doing my word, making istighfar, long sajda, long ruku'. Like Uwais al-Qarani would say, tonight is the night of ruku'. We spend it in very, 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 very long ruku'. And we say, tonight is the night night of sujood, tonight is the night of qiyam. طيب. وبه إليه قال حدثنا عبد الله قال حدثني محمد بن الحسين قال حدثنا زيد بن الحباب قال حدثنا حوشب بن عقيل قال سمعت يزيد الرقاشي يقول لما حضره الموت. The same Yazid, one of the companions of Anas ibn Malik, who is famous for his piety and worship, devotion. On his deathbed, he said, كل نفس ذائقة الموت وإنما توفون أجوركم يوم القيامة. Every soul shall taste death, and it is but your own rewards, your own recompense that you are going to be repaid in full on the day of resurrection. Or you shall be repaid your rewards in full only on the day of resurrection. So the innama adat al-hasr can be applied to either it is but your own rewards, yani don't blame anyone and be happy for what you did, or only at that time will you be repaid your rewards, depending how you read it. ألا إن الأعمال محضرة. So he reads it. Also his comment applies to both meanings. It says truly, lo and behold, deeds are certainly going to be brought to appear one by one, all of them. وَالْأُجُورُ مُكْمَلَةٌ And rewards will be repaid in full. وَلِكُلِّ سَاعٍ مَا يَسْعَى And for every doer, there is what he did or she. وَغَايَةُ الدُّنْيَا وَأَهْلِهَا إِلَى الْمَوْتِ As for this world and its people, their ending all ends up in death. يعني nothing remains in this world. ثُمَّ بَكَى Then he wept. وَقَالْ يَا مَنِ الْقَبْرُ مَسْكَنُهُ Addressing himself and all people who are at the point of death or who will die one day. يعني all human beings, all living things that are bound for death. يَا مَنِ الْقَبْرُ مَسْكَنُهُ Oh, you whose final abode, whose final residence is the grave. وَبَيْنَ يَدَيِ اللَّهِ مَوْقِفُهُ Who shall be made to stand in front of Allah. وَالنَّارُ غَدًا مَوْرِدُهُ And who shall be made to taste of the fire. Because every soul shall taste of death. وَإِن مِنْكُمْ إِلَّا وَارِدُهَا كَانَ عَلَىٰ رَبِّكَ حَتْمًا مَقْضِيًّا يعني everyone shall come to taste of that. وَالْعِيَذُ بِاللَّهِ So he says, ماذا قدمت لنفسك? What have you prepared for your soul? So there will be some who will come over the fire, but they will be protected. And what is meant by the verse is crossing over the fire on the Sirat. So for some who will be protected, they will go very fast and it will be a very wide bridge. They'll be aware of the fire, and they will feel it, but they'll be going fast over it and over a wide bridge. Others will be going much slower, 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 slower. So some like the lightning of a lightning, others like a speeding racehorse, others more slowly, others finally on their hands and knees or on their faces, even when I use billah. And for some, it will be narrow until it is as narrow as a hair or as the sharp edge of the sword. So what have we prepared for that? As the Prophet ﷺ said to the man who was asking, when is the day of resurrection? What have you prepared for that? Because look what you have to go through. Not something to be desired at all by anyone. ماذا أعددت لمصرعك? What have you prepared for your demise, for your destruction? ماذا أعددت لوقوفك بين يدي ربك? What have you prepared for your station in front of your Lord? به إليه قال حدثني محمد قال حدثني الصلت بن حكيم قال حدثنا درست القزاز So this is a Persian name, درست, not an Arab name. قال لما احتضر يزيد الرقاشي بكى When Yazid al-Raqashi was on the point of death, he wept. فَقِيلَ لَهُ مَا يُبْكِيكَ رَحِمَكَ اللَّهُ Why are you crying? Allah grant you mercy. قَالَ أَبْكِ وَاللَّهِ عَلَى مَا يَفُوتُنِي مِنْ قِيَامِ اللَّيْلِ وَصِيَامِ النَّهَارِ Now it is clear. I am weeping by Allah over what I'm going to be missing of standing up in prayer at night and fasting in the day. All this will be gone. ثم بكى وقال من يصلي لك يا يزيد He wept and he said who is going to pray on your behalf O Yazid ومن يصوم See in Shafi'i Mazhab it is allowed to pray for others to fast for others but and who has even you know the presence of heart and to pray for themselves to fast for themselves so much less for others and this is what he is he's regretting. وَمَنْ يَتَقَرَّبُ لَكَ إِلَى اللَّهِ بِالْأَعْمَالِ بَعْدَكَ So who is going to try to come near to Allah on your behalf with good deeds after you are gone? وَمَنْ يَتُوبُ لَكَ إِلَيْهِ مِنَ الذُّنُوبِ السَّالِفَةِ Who is going to ask forgiveness on your behalf from Allah for past sins? وَيْحَكُمْ يَا إِخْوَتَاهُ Woe to you, O my brothers, لا تغترن بشبابكم. Don't let your youth, your young age, delude you. Don't let it fool you. فكأن قد حل بكم. It seems as if next minute it's going to happen to you too. And in other words, time passes so fast. Not that the very next minute, but the fact that 30, 60, 90 years might pass like a one moment. It's all the same when it, in hindsight, in retrospective, time is tricking us. So don't be tricked. And the dunya is blinding us. Don't be blinded. Now, ما حل بي من عظيم الأمر وشدة كرب الموت. As if it will happen to you very quickly, just what is happening to me now of this huge matter and most difficult tests that I'm or ordeal that I'm going through, which is death. النجاة, which is the same of نجات as نجات. So salvation. الحذر الحذر. يا إخوتاه, beware, be careful, cautious, oh brothers. المبادرة, رحمكم الله. Go and do quickly what you can still do. يعني بادروا يعني go and do good deeds. بادروا إلى العمل الصالح, الصالحات الباقيات. وبه إليه قال حدثني عبيد الله بن محمد التيمي قال حدثني بعض أشياخنا أن رجلا من علية هذه الأمة حضرته الوفاة. One of the most pious or one of the great eminent ones of this Ummah. So he's not naming or he forgot his name or not naming this Wali, that death came to him. فَجَزِعَ جَزَعًا شَدِيدًا. And he was seized with great fear. كَثِيرًا. And he wept very hard. فَقِيلَ لَهُ فِي ذَلِكَ. So he was asked why. فقال, he replied, مَا أَبْكِ إِلَّا عَلَىٰ أَنْ يَصُومَ الصَّائِمُونَ لِلَّهِ وَلَسْتُ فِيهِمْ. I only weep because there's going to be people fasting for Allah, but I'm not going to be among them. وَيُصَلِّي لَهُ الْمُصَلُّونَ وَلَسْتُ فِيهِمْ. And there will be people worshipping and praying to him, and I'm not going to be among them. وَيَذْكُرَ الذَّاكِرُونَ وَلَسْتُ فِيهِمْ. And making zikr, I'm not among them. فَذَاكَ الَّذِي أَبْكَانِي. That is what made me weep. See, and this is in reference to the hadith of the Prophet ﷺ, that those who make zikr when others are not making zikr are like the living among the dead. So, and this is understood literally, because when we die, all deeds stop, they come to an end. This is why some of the awliya Allah ask for Allah to be still praying even in the grave after death, to be still reciting Quran because they loved it so much. So if they were sincere, from the sincere ones, Allah may accept from them. And this has been witnessed as miracles of the awliya after death. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows best of the hearts of his servants, and is well able to give them that if he wishes. وبه إليه قال حدثني محمد بن الحسين قال حدثنا خالد بن عمرو قال حدثنا أبو إسرائيل الملائي عن الحكم أنه قال لما احتضر عبد الرحمن بن الأسود بكى. This one is another of the great fuqaha of Al-Kufa, and he narrates from many companions, so he is a tabi'i. فقيل له ما يبكيك. So on his deathbed, he wept hard and he was asked why. قال أسفا على الصوم والصلاة. Again, because I regret deeply fasting and prayer. قال ولم يزل يقرأ القرآن حتى مات. And Al-Hakam said that Abdul Rahman did not stop reading Quran until he died. قال فرؤي له أنه من أهل الجنة. So someone dreamt of him, and it might be the very one who is narrating this, Al-Hakam, that this Abdul Rahman was among the people of paradise. قال وكان الحكم يقول. So the one who narrates from Al-Hakam said that Al-Hakam said ولا يبعد من ذاك, and it is not far-fetched to say that he is of people of paradise. You see, they are afraid to say it literally or to affirm it positively, so they say it's not far-fetched, it is not improbable. And we like to think that he is one of them, but it's up to Allah. Out of respect, we say we do not affirm positively. لقد كان يعمل نفسه or يعمل نفسه مجتهدا لهذا. يعني he would exert himself and ply himself and pressure himself and do efforts towards that. حذرا من مصرعه الذي صار إليه. Fully cautious of his impending demise that he finally reached. اللهم صل على سيدنا. وبه إليه حدثني محمد قال حدثنا بدل ابن المحبر قال حدثنا سعيد قال دخلت على زبيد الإيامي. I went in to see زبيد الإيامي, one of the also pious tabi'in, في مرضه الذي مات فيه, in his final illness. فقلت شفاك الله. I said to him, Allah give you cure and healing. فقال أستخير الله. Meaning, I leave it up to him. Let it be his choice. به إليه حدثني محمد قال حدثني القاسم بن عمرو بن محمد قال حدثنا المحاربي عن إدريس بن يزيد الأودي أنه قال دخلنا على عطية وهو يجود بنفسه. Went in to see عطية and he was straining his breath. يعني he was on his deathbed. فقلنا كيف تجدك رحمك الله. How do you feel? May Allah grant you mercy. فدمعت عيناه. His eyes filled with tears. وقال أجدني. I feel. والله. I swear by Allah. إلى الآخرة أقرب مني إلى الدنيا. Closer to the next world than to this world. So he's weeping, thinking of himself in that state. That he cannot. Maybe. يعني we imagine what he must have felt like. That he cannot believe that he's there already. What is going to happen next, and what has he prepared? Nothing, not enough, he's afraid, and so forth. Not that he's leaving this dunya in the traditional sense of, you know, being afraid of death, because it is all in line with what precedes and what follows. It says فَمَنْ اسْتَطَاعَ مِنْكُمْ أَنْ يَعْمَلَ لِمِثْلِ هَذَا السُّرَعَةِ فَلْيَفْعَلْ. So whoever among you is able to prepare towards this champion wrestler, the Sura'a, let them do it. The Sura'a. Like we say, Ruhala, the one who travels a lot. Ruhala. So, Sura'a, and there's many, many words like that saying champion this, champion that. So here in this case is about Musara'a. لَيْسَ الْقَوِيَّ الَّذِي يُصَارِعَ النَّاسِ. Prophet ﷺ said, like the strong one is not the one who is able to wrestle down people, يُصَارِعَ النَّاسِ. بل القوي أو لكن القوي الذي يملك نفسه عند الغضب. Controls himself at the time of anger. That is the strong one. وبه إليه قال حدثني محمد قال حدثنا عمر بن حفص بن غياث قال حدثني أبي قال لما احتضر عمرو بن قيس الملائي بكى. Another Kufi of the great imams of Kufa, and Sufyan al-Thawri respected him greatly and would visit him for barakah and give him great respect. So he was among the devotees and the prayerful, worshipful, pious awliya of Al-Kufa in Iraq. On his deathbed, he wept. فَقَالَ لَهُ أَصْحَابُهُ عَلَى مَا تَبْكِي مِنَ الدُّنْيَا فَوَاللَّهِ لَقَدْ كُنْتَ مُنْغَصَّ الْعَيْشِ مُنْغَصَّ الْعَيْشِ أَيَّامَ حَيَاتِكَ. His friend said to him, are you weeping over this dunya? Over what? From this world are you weeping? We swear that your life was a life of troubles and deprivation. Oh, yani all the days of your life, you were living in straitened conditions. So you should be happy, in other words. فَقَالَ وَاللَّهِ مَا أَبْكِي عَلَى الدُّنْيَا. I swear by Allah, I'm not weeping over this world. إِنَّمَا أَبْكِي خَوْفًا أَنْ أُحْرَمَ خَيْرَ الْآخِرَةِ. I am only weeping out of fear that I would be deprived of the goodness of the next world. اللهم صل وسلم. به لي حدثني محمد قال حدثني مطير ابن الربيع قال كان مفضل ابن يونس إذا جاء الليل قال مفضل ابن يونس would say whenever night fell ذهب من عمري يوم كامل. From my lifespan a whole day has gone never to return. فإذا أصبح قال ذهبت ليلة كاملة من عمري. And in the morning upon rising he would say a whole night of my lifetime has gone, never to return. And this is in the Hadith Sharif, that to say that upon sunset, Allahumma adbara naharuka wa aqdama layluka faghfir li. Oh Allah, your day has gone that you gave me. Now it has gone. You took it back, never to be mine again. And your night has come, so therefore, forgive me. And then in the morning, Allahumma adbara layluka wa aqbala naharuka, ghafir li, again. So to be forgiven for the loss of that day that we did not put it into profit, or for the loss of that night we did not put it into profit. فَلَمَّا احْتُدِرَ. And when death came to him, بَكَى وَقَال, he wept and said, قَدْ كُنْتُ أَعْلَمُ أَنَّ لِي مِنْ كَرِّكُمَا. عَلَيَّ يَوْمًا شَدِيدًا كَرْبُهُ شَدِيدًا غُصَصُهُ شَدِيدًا غَمُّهُ شَدِيدًا عَلْزُهُ. الله أكبر. He said on his deathbed, I knew that your coming and going and leaving me quickly, meaning you, the day and the night. So he's addressing time. Because he would address each of his days and each of his nights like that. So he's still addressing them and saying, you're leaving me quickly, you're running away from me. I knew that it would lead up to this terrible day. A day that is a heavy calamity, a day that is brutal in its bitterness. يعني غصة, غصت نفسه, يعني experience maybe bitterness in himself or something like acidity. شديدا غمه, very depressing. الغم والهم, depression or intense sadness and dejection. And شديد العلزه, so العلز القلق والفزع, intensely anxious. فلا إله إلا الذي قضى الموت على خلقه وميزه عدلا بين عباده. Truly there is no God but the one who has decreed death for his creatures, for his creation, and has also given it a place of justice among his servants. يعني death is just, it's not just decreed by Allah as an injustice that he decrees, harsha. Decrees it and it's just. And everything from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is either from his favor or from his justice. And we are asking for his favor to prevail over his justice. Because no one can escape from his justice. And no one can be safe from if he is to be just with everyone. But if he shows favor, then we are safe, inshallah. ثم جعل يقرأ. And then he started reading, الذي خلق الموت والحياة ليبلوكم أيكم أحسن عملا. The one who created death and life in order to test you, who among you has the best deed. And you see, this is Islamic doctrine. That Allah created death, that death has an actual existence. It is not just the absence of life, as in Christian doctrine, that death is only the absence of life, but it does not have a positive existence or an actual existence. This is not Islamic doctrine. Islamic doctrine is that Allah has created death as well as life, as said verbatim here, but that death shall be one day annihilated. Death shall be brought one day in the form of a ram that shall be slaughtered in front of the inhabitants of heaven and in front of the inhabitants of hell. And then a caller shall call at that, after that time, there is no death after this. Whoever is, wherever they are, that's it. Life without end and life without death. So let us ask for Allah to put us in the best place for life without end, in Jannah, in paradise with his elect. Ameen. وَهُوَ الْعَزِيزُ الْغَفُورُ. And he, Most High, is the mighty and the all-forgiving. ثُمَّ تَنَفَّسَ فَخَرَجَتْ نَفْسُهُ. Then he gave up his last breath. بِهِلَيْ حَدَّثَنِي مُحَمَّدُ بْنُ الْحُسَيْنِ قَالَ حَدَّثَنَا رُسْتُمُ بْنُ أُسَامَةَ قَالَ حَدَّثَنَا جَعْفَرُ بْنُ سُلَيْمَانَ قَالَ لَمَّا حُضِرَ أَبُو عِمْرَانَ الْجُنِيُّ جَعَلَ يَبْكِي. And this one is a great muhaddith. He wept at the time of death. فَقِيلَ لَهُ مَا يُبْكِيكَ رَحِمَكَ اللَّهُ. Why are you weeping? Allah grant you mercy. قَالَ ذَكَرْتُ وَاللَّهِ تَفْرِيطِي فَبَكِيتُ أو فَبَكِيتُ. I remembered by Allah my neglectfulness. I'm remiss in so much, so that's what makes me weep. On all the occasions that we missed doing good, or all the occasions we missed not doing something bad, something that we regret. So all of that becomes clear and visible again at that time. And so we should be happy to be in such a state even before the time of death, because then maybe we can improve ourselves when we are still able to. But at that time, it's all finished. So all the more the reason for weeping. وَبِهِ إِلَيْهِ حَدَّثَنِي مُحَمَّدْ قَالَ حَدَّثَنِي شُعَيْثْ ابْنُ مُحْرِزْ قَالَ حَدَّثَنَا الربيع ابن صبيح قال لما احتضر محمد بن واسع. Again the same one as we saw before. جعل إخوانه يقولون له أبشر يا أبا عبد الله فإنا نرجو لك. So his brethren around him started saying to him, be glad, receive good news, oh Abu Abdullah, because we have the best high hopes for you. We have high hopes for you that Allah will put you in paradise. فبكى. He wept. ثم قال يذهب بي إلى النار أو يعفو الله. No, I'm going to be taken to hellfire or Allah will forgive me. And in other words, don't put into my head the idea that I am saved, then I go out of this life with arrogance or with the feeling that I am better than others. So he was afraid of that. وبه إليه حدثني محمد قال حدثنا خالد بن يزيد القرني القراني. قال حدثنا فضالة ابن دينار قال حضرت محمد بن واسع وقد سجدي للموت. I was present when Muhammad ibn Wasi' had been covered for death. يعني meaning that they had given him his last breath as he was still alive, or his last, you know, the clothing as he was still alive. So he was had been covered for death, as if dressed for death, not yet in his shroud, but this is what it reads as, but he's still alive. يعني he's that near to death. فجعل يقول, and he started saying, مرحبا بملائكة ربي, welcome to the angels of my Lord. ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله, and there is no change nor might except with Allah. قال وشممت رائحة طيبة لم أشمم مثلها, and I smelled a good smell that I never smelled before. قال ثم شخص ببصره فمات. Then he looked up and then he died. So this is a frequent gesture of those giving up their last breath, to look up. And no one knows if they are looking at something, or if they are just, or if it is just a normal gesture of the body at that time, the tension that happens and release. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows best. And it has been said, perhaps it is mentioned in Kitab al-Ruh of Ibn al-Qayyim, which examines in detail these issues, that they see somehow the soul that comes out can become coming out from through any part of the body. That if it comes out from the top, either from the head or from the mouth, then they can, and this is reserved for a good death. And if it comes out from the feet, it is a difficult death, strenuous, strained death. And Allah knows best. But they see it. It is as if it has a shape, or it may be personified, or a recognizable form. And they follow it up until it disappears from their sight, or until their sight is no longer able to follow, and presumably being carried up by the angels of mercy. So that means it's a good death. And so the angels might be the angels of mercy, or, wal'iyaz billah, we seek refuge in Allah from that, the angels of punishment, if it is not a good death. طيب. وبه إليه. عن عبد الله بن المبارك قال حدثني حماد بن سعيد بن أبي عطية المذبوح قال لما حضر أبا عطية الموت جزع منه. وعطية, when he was about to die, he feared death. فقيل له أتجزع من الموت, are you afraid of death؟ فقال وما لي لا أجزع, why shouldn't I be afraid, وإنما هي ساعة ثم لا أدري أين يسلك بي. Because even though it's just a moment, إنما هي ساعة, so we said that ساعة in classical Arabic is a moment, not 60 minutes like in modern Arabic. But after that, I don't know where I'm going to be taken. So سلوك here, يسلك بي, where I'm going to be driven. طيب, وبه لا حدثني أبي رحمه الله. So عبد الله, now the Imam, the author of this book, Ibn Abu Dunya, he's saying his father narrated this to him. حدثني أبي رحمه الله. So he has a pious dua for his father. He did not say رحمه الله for all the other narrators from whom he narrated. This is his father, so he says حدثني أبي رحمه الله. عن أبي خالد القرشي عن سفيان الثوري عن رجل قال لما احتضر إبراهيم النخعي بكى. One of the great imams of the Salaf al-Salih and the Tabi'in of Kufa also. When he was dying, he wept. فقيل له ما يبكيك؟ Why are you weeping? قال أنتظر رسول ربي. I am waiting for the messengers of my Lord. Then, so now this is understood here in square brackets. He's saying then they will take me. And he continues, إما لجنة وإما لنار. Either to a paradise or to a fire. فالله سبحانه وتعالى take us all to paradise. آمين. وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين. الحمد لله رب العالمين. Thanks for joining. إن شاء الله we'll see you next week. Same time.